Hello everyone. In the previous video we have seen introduction for hydrothermal scheduling. Now here in this video we'll see what are the different categories of hydrothermal scheduling, and also we'll see different algorithms for hydrothermal scheduling. For hydrothermal scheduling, and also we'll see different nomenclatures used in the algorithms. So let us begin. So first we'll see what are the different categories of hydrothermal scheduling. So there are basically three categories. So the first one is when the system is having only hydro plants. So the scheduling of the system if there is only hydro plants. This is actually a very rare case. The constraint here is only the water inflow, because the cost, the operation cost of hydro plants are very less compared to the production cost or the operation cost of thermal plants. So if suppose there are only hydro plants, the constraint for the system is only the water flow. So only the water flow will be the constraint here. But anyways, this case is very rare. So we don't have only hydro systems or only hydro plants. So anyways, the power system is combination of hydro and thermal. So we'll be discussing here the combination of hydro and thermal. So this is the first type. And the second one, what we have is system where majority of the generation is hydro. So the combination of hydro and thermal, and where the majority is hydro plant. Here the scheduling is done to minimize cost of the thermal system. So we know that the operation cost of the thermal system is very high. If suppose we need to minimize the cost of the thermal plants, then we have to go for this classification, that is where the majority of the generation is based on hydro system. And the third one is actually the balance between thermal and hydro, or you can say it's a combination of thermal and hydro combination. And again, we have to maintain the balance between thermal and hydro. That is the third category, or you can say it is just a thermal system, or we can tell where the hydro plants form a minor portion. So these are the three different categories of the hydrothermal systems. So now let us see what are the different algorithms used for the hydrothermal scheduling. So different algorithms for hydrothermal schedulings are, we have basically four types of algorithms. So these are the four algorithms. So in that, first one is scheduling based on energy. So based on the hydro energy and also on the thermal energy, we'll do the scheduling. That is a algorithm for hydrothermal scheduling based on energy. That is the first one. And the second algorithm what we have is short range scheduling using gamma and lambda iterations, based on iteration procedure. So we'll see, while discussing this particular algorithm, we'll discuss about what is short range scheduling and what are these type of iterations, we'll discuss later. So the third one is general hydrothermal scheduling using discrete time intervals. And the fourth one what we have is short range scheduling using penalty factors. So we'll see, now we'll see the nomenclature used for different algorithms. So under nomenclatures, we have a first one, that is PGTK. So this tells you that this is the nomenclature for generated thermal or thermal generation in the kth interval. So this is thermal generation in the kth interval. So thermal generation in the kth interval. Second one what we have is PGHK. So this is hydro generation in the kth time interval. So I can write here hydro generation So second nomenclature what we have is hydro generation in the kth time interval. So you need to remember all these nomenclatures. So for all the four algorithms we'll be using the same nomenclatures. So the first one what we have is a thermal generation in the kth time interval. This is hydro generation in the kth time interval, and capital N stands for total number of time intervals. So if suppose we have a term interval, how many discrete intervals we can split it into? So that is nothing but total number of time intervals. So that is represented by N, and K is nothing but we have used here a particular time interval, that is a particular interval, time interval. So K stands for a particular time interval. So K can take values from 1, 2, 3 till N. We said the total time is divided into N number of time intervals. So out of N number of time intervals, which is the present time interval, that will be represented by K. So if suppose I write PGT3, this represents that K value is 3, and this tells you that the thermal generation in the third time interval. So next one, next nomenclature is NT, which is nothing but number of time intervals thermal plant is on. So NT stands for number of time intervals for which thermal plant is on. Similarly, NH, if you take, this is nothing but number of time intervals So this is NH is for number of time intervals for which hydro plant is on, or you can simply say NH is N minus NT, total number of time intervals minus number of time intervals for which thermal plant is on. So next one what we have is HK, that is nothing but number of hours in the kth time interval. So HK is number of hours in the kth time interval. When I say the entire time interval is split into different intervals, we say that each interval has H number of hours in it. So H number of hours can be mentioned by HK, where K gives us particularly in which interval we are analyzing. So next one is PDK. So PD stands for power demand or load. So demand or load in the kth interval. So PDK stands for power demand or load power in kth interval, kth time interval. Then we have P loss K, which is nothing but power loss in the kth time interval. Power loss in the kth time interval. Power loss in the kth time interval. Then we have Q in K. So this is actually the water inflow in the kth time interval. This is basically the constraint for hydro plants. So water inflow in the kth time interval. And the unit of this is meter cube per second or meter cube per hour, or you can say liter per second or liter per hour. Next one, what we have is QOK. So this is nothing but water outflow, or you can call it as water discharge. Water discharge in the kth interval. Again, the unit is here meter cube per second, or you can say liter per second, or you can write meter cube per hour or liter per hour. So this is for water discharge. Next one, what we have is the Tmax. Tmax. Tmax is total time. And last one, what we have nomenclature is TT. TT is a total time for which the thermal plant is on. So from this, TT is total time for which the thermal plant is on. So from this you can write TH is T total time for which hydropower plant is on. So you can directly write TH is nothing but T max minus TT. So all these nomenclatures are very important. So for the different algorithms what we study. Thank you.